Cura 4.6 is out. In fact, they've already got an update, Cura 4.6.1. So I'm still playing with it. I've tried out my profiles, but there's one feature that I'm really excited about. So I'm going to show you that one on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. I made this really simple test print in Tinkercad. It's 32 millimeters tall, 90 millimeters wide. And if I check the holes here, I have a 20 millimeter hole. So you can see 20 millimeters by 20 millimeters, a 15 millimeter hole in the center, and then a 10 millimeter hole on the end. And I have labels 20, 10, and 15. So now I'm gonna export this, bring it into Cura, and here it is, and you can check it. It's 90 millimeters by 32, so all that looks fine. It's the holes I'm really worried about. So I'm gonna slice this with my CHEP 0.2 layer height, slice it, and then take a look at it in preview. It takes 45 minutes to print, pretty simple print. Looks good. Here's the print, so let's take some measurements. Should be 32 millimeters, 32 millimeters. Should be 90 millimeters tall, 90 millimeters. So how about the holes? 20 millimeter hole, 19.5 small. 15 millimeter hole, 14.5, half a millimeter small. 10 millimeter hole, 9.5. All three holes are 0.5 millimeters too small. But the dimension here and the dimension lengthwise are spot on. So if I want to use horizontal expansion in Cura to adjust these holes, make them bigger, I'm also going to make this bigger this way and longer this way. That's what I don't want. Well, that's the new feature in Cura. I can adjust just the holes. Let me show you that. First of all, let me prove to you I'm using version 4.6.1 of Cura. So let's look for horizontal expansion. And now there are three options. Horizontal expansion, initial layer horizontal expansion, and then hole horizontal expansion. That's the one I'm going to work with here. Initial horizontal expansion is something for a future video that will help you get rid of elephant's foot. So we're going to look at this one. The holes were 0.5 too small, but that's the diameter. So we want the radius here, 0.25. We'll make it 0.25 larger. So let's slice this. If I want to make it smaller, I would make it a negative number. But here it is sliced, 45 minutes to slice it. I can scroll through, make sure it looks good. And it does, except for the top. Look at these numbers. 10, which has a zero in it, which is a hole, and 20 has a zero in it, which is a hole, are both affected by horizontal expansion. And just proof of that, I'll get rid of it and slice it and look at the back. The zero on both the 10 and the 20 are back normal. So that's one issue to deal with, but let's see what it does to the holes. So 0.25, slice it again, and let's print it out. So here's the new print. Let's see if I can get this to focus. Yeah, you can see the zero on the 20 and on the 10 are messed up, just like it showed in Cura. So if I can get a little closer here, you can see how they're really messed up. So those are circles that horizontal expansion affected in a negative way. So now, what about the dimensions? So let's check it here. 32, that didn't change. 90. So that's pretty close to spot on. Now the holes. 20 millimeter hole. 20 millimeters. Exactly. 15 millimeter hole. 15 millimeters. 10 millimeter hole. 10.1. 10 millimeters. So the horizontal expansion worked great. Only affected the holes and then the zeros on the 20 and 10. So that I can deal with. I can make those maybe a little bit bigger, the text. But getting the holes perfect without affecting these outer dimensions, that's what I love. That's a nice feature to have in your slicer. This is the first feature of 4.6.1 that I've been able to dive deep into. I got this working. Another one they have is expansion on just the first couple layers. That way, if you have elephant's foot on your prints, you can eliminate it by reducing those first layers. So I'm gonna set up a machine to really produce some really good or really bad elephant's foot and see if I can correct it with that. Another thing I'm working on is the changing filament at height. There was a multicolor CHEP tube I did in a previous video where it would pause, you change the filament so you could do multicolors. And some people were reporting a version like 4.4, 4.5, that the Z stepper motor wasn't holding and that it would actually slip while they're changing filament and mess the whole thing up. Well, apparently that was an issue because in 4.6, at least 4.6.1, they have fixed it. So now you can actually tell how long you want the Z-axis motor to freeze, to hold. Up to 30 minutes, that's the max. So you can set that and guarantee that it will freeze. Now, I never had that problem on when I did that video, but that was in an earlier version of Cura, and I haven't tested a whole lot since then. So now I'm playing with that to make sure that this freeze is actually gonna work. So that'll be a follow-up video. So hopefully this gives you a reason to download 4.6.1 and start playing with it. I don't know how many times I've done a design, everything looked good except the holes. And I'd have to drill out the holes because they were just too small. Now I can adjust it right in the slicer. I love that. So if you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up. And please click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. That way you don't miss an episode. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.